Good morning, Parkside. This is Chris, and this is my story. So I was privileged to grow up in a Christian home, so I was able to find God at 12, and unfortunately, like most Christians, started off really on fire and became a lukewarm Christian. And that being said, drugs, violence, and chaos of the world for the 30 years I've been a Christian, 27 of them, I was just lukewarm. And about three, almost 4 years ago now, I kind of figured out that I needed to love myself if I was going to really love others, including the Lord. That being said, I was able to have God lift off the burdens of my life at that day about 4 years ago, which was alcohol, which I used alcohol as a crutch. Became an absolute alcoholic in order to stay away from the drugs and other things that I did of old, which was a bad choice for sure. But it also led me to where I am today. I'm grateful for God always staying with me. So where I am today, biggest thing in my heart is the Great Commission. And Great Commission being that, you know, for those 27 years or so, I was failing God, dragging him through the muck and the chaos with me, and not doing what he called me to all those years ago. And that's to spread his word and share his love. So today, you know, found a great home here at Parkside. Super place to be, especially for a guy like me. Definitely not a perfect kind of guy. But super blessed. Through this walk, God's led me to my wife, which we have two beautiful sons, and he enabled me to somehow, and even the drunken chaos, witness to her through my walk, and she found God. One of the most proudest things of my moment, you would think, would be the birth of my two sons, my daughter, what have you, and it's far from that. One of the greatest days of my life was the glorification of God coming into my wife's life. So the other thing that's super big on my heart that we forget about is seniors. Kind of cast them away, if you will. And the thing is, with seniors is they forget sometimes, you know, who they are or whatever, and it makes it hard to talk to them or whatever, but nevertheless, I feel it's a big thing on my heart to make sure that I'm in there, and you know, if I see seniors and such, I just make it a point to let them know that God's in me, and that it's on my heart that they know that they're loved. My name is Chris Johnson, and that's my story.